What is up, guys? What is going on? Now, I'm gonna cut from the intro and I'm just gonna give you guys a quick thought that came through my mind. A little bit different from the videos that we normally do, but for those of you wanting to get into the trade, for those of you wanting to become a automotive technician or a diesel technician, let me speak to you guys really, really quickly. Don't ever do this job for free. Don't work on anyone's stuff for free, even if you're trying to help them out. And I'm gonna let you know why. Now, if they're a good family or a good friend and you willingly want to do that, you willingly in your heart and soul say, hey, I know you're going through tough times, you really need this vehicle to get from point A to B, let me help you out, then fine, go ahead and do that. You know, it's okay, do that. But if people are well off, they can afford it, I mean, obviously you're never gonna know what people can afford, what people can't afford, but if people can afford it, people are well off, and they ask you, hey, I need you to look at my truck, or hey, I need you to look at my car, or whatever it is, charge them. And I'm gonna tell you why. Now, I don't mean to charge them an arm and a leg and expect that to rip them off. I'm not gonna tell you to do that. I'm gonna obviously charge them fairly. And when you charge these people fairly, they're obviously gonna come back to you. Now, if they're really real friends and real family members of yours, they will support your business. They will know that you're charging them fairly because other shops will take advantage of them. You obviously don't have to take advantage. You can charge them fairly. You must know what fair is. You must know how long the job is going to take. You must know what you can do, how fast you can do it. Obviously, you don't need to mark up prices on parts for someone that you're trying to help out. You can tell them to get the parts yourself instead of you having to go and get it, because that's your time. And honestly, time is money. Don't let anyone take advantage of your time. And one thing I've noticed ever since getting into the trade of automotive or diesel technician, as soon as anyone finds out that you do this kind of work, this field of work, they instantly want to take advantage. They instantly want you to start fixing everything. You're gonna start seeing everyone's vehicle starts having problems. Everyone's gonna obviously come to you for answers. Everyone's gonna want something for free. And like, certain things you can get away with. Obviously, if someone's like, hey, my air conditioning is not really blowing as hard or blowing as cold, and you think it's a clogged cabin filter, well, to change the cabin filter, come on, go buy the part. I'm not gonna charge you to change that. It's not gonna take me even 2 minutes to change that. Why would I charge you for that? Places charge $80 to do that. That's a ripoff. But obviously time is money, so I think it's a ripoff to charge $80. You could charge like 10 bucks to do it or something, or $5 or something like that. But to do something small like that, and the car's right there, and they really just ask you for your help, you can do it for them. But other things like brakes or things like engine diagnostics and stuff like that, that really takes some of your time. That stuff takes an hour. It could take 2 hours. Sometimes you can diagnose in 30 minutes. But the reason they have to pay you for that is because it's the knowledge in your head that you went to school for, that you studied, that you took the time out of your day, out of your life, to know what it is that you need to know in order to figure out how to fix whatever problems their vehicle's going through. Some people don't realize that. Some people don't realize that your scanner cost money, that your tools cost money. Some people don't realize that your education itself cost money. They think that everything is free, that you didn't have to pay for anything, that you just know this off the top of your head because this was info you were born with, and they figure you owe them something and you must help them. That's not how it works. Some people you'll notice will cry and make it seem like they didn't have nothing, make it seem like they're really on the low and they need help, and then all of a sudden you see them going to a bar, living it up, going to parties, buying expensive clothes, spending their money on all kinds of other stuff, but they couldn't support you and help you on your business because your time was worth nothing to them other than helping them do something for free. I have one best friend, and I'm gonna be real with y'all. Not a lot of people know that. I have one best friend in New Jersey, and I don't keep a lot of friends. I'm not the type of guy that likes to have too many friends around me because today in this day and age, a lot of people don't know the real meaning of friendship anymore. People don't know the meaning of keeping to their word. And this one friend that I have, I never used to charge him to fix anything. And one day, I had tons of friends. He was one of them. And one day, I decided to start charging all my friends. Not crazy, charge them a little something. You want breaks? I'll charge you $20 to do them. $40, whatever. And every single one of them, except one, dropped off. Never came back. Never wanted me to do anything. And only one, that one best friend that I have, was willing to pay me. And he even paid me more than what I asked and tipped also. And I was like, bro, you know what? Keep your money, man. I don't want it. I don't want it. Because I just wanted to see the type of people that they were. And some people might say that I am testing people, but it's not. But you know what? Yes, I am. I am testing people. I'm testing people to see their judge of character, who they are. Because I'm the type of person that if I ask you, hey, man, my car's giving me an issue. Can you look at it for me? I'm going to pay you. Even if you tell me no, I'm going to give you something because I know what it's worth. Even if I have an issue at home and I'm like, hey, my water is not turning on or something. Can you check it out? And they come out and do me a favor. No, man, I don't need nothing. You're all good. You're cool, man. And I'm just like, no, man, here, hold this. No matter who comes to my house, even the guy who sets up the cable in the house, the Wi-Fi, the internet, whenever they come over, I tip them. I know how to treat people. You want to treat people the way you want to be treated. But that's besides the point. Anyway, this one best friend, he obviously supports me. And that's what I'm trying to tell you guys. If you guys have a business, you open up a business, you're into this trade, you're doing things that, you know, you went to school for, you spent a lot of money in, not everyone's going to support you. Everyone's going to figure you owe them something. Everyone's going to think that you have to do this for free. No, you don't. Say no. Say you don't have time. Learn to say no. The more you say no, the better for you. Because you don't need that headache. And no matter how much you really, really want to help, say no. Because at the end of the day, majority of those people that you help will never help you back. And I guarantee that. And it sucks to say that. And it sucks to be very negative because I'm always very positive on my channel. But I'm also very real at the same time. And unfortunately, the way that the world works today is not a lot of people have your best interests at heart. They don't think about the fact that you have to drive from point A to B to meet them. They don't think that your time in traffic to meet them. They don't think about your time that you sat there to diagnose in either the hot sun or in their hot garage or breaking your knuckles just to fix something in there. They don't think about that stuff. They just want to know that it was fixed. You did them that favor. Cool. I'll call you later. And you must also realize that there are some people out there who only call you when there's an issue. And other than that, you'll never hear from them again when everything's going fine. Be very wary of those people. Now, I'm speaking to the entire world of people who are doing this automotive stuff, this diesel stuff. And I'm just gonna let people know straight up, I love doing this as a hobby. Me working in this diesel field, automotive field, working for employers, working for myself, meeting the different people. I enjoyed meeting the different people and working for myself. I did. But now I don't want any part of it anymore, to tell you guys the truth. I do not want any part of it anymore. I have decided to pursue something else. I don't know what it is yet. I obviously enjoy doing these videos. I enjoy teaching you guys whatever it is that I know or whatever it is that I try to figure out. I enjoy making these videos. I love this stuff. I think it's cool having the communication with the community. I think it's awesome. But doing it as a career, I kind of started to dislike it. And it started to affect into my hobby as well of building cars and doing that, because every day it's the same thing in and out of me touching a vehicle and just learning not to like it anymore. And that's one thing I want to say to you guys is if you enjoy this as a hobby, do not get into it as a career. Some people may enjoy it so much that they do it as a career and a hobby. But if you really want to do it as a career, open up your own business. I urge you to do that, guys, because you're going to be so much happier than working for a boss, than listening to what they have to tell you, than them telling you, no, you need to do this at this time. I don't care. Get it done however you need to do it. Take shortcuts, whatever it is. Don't let anyone tell you to take shortcuts as well, because shortcuts lead to a lot of issues. And even though they tell you to take the shortcuts, at the end of the day, it's on you and you're gonna get in trouble. And that was a big B, and we don't like that back here. So anyway, that's all I wanted to say to you guys. I wanted you guys to know where I'm coming from with this, and I wanted you guys to understand that I'm not trying to be negative, but I'm just trying to give you guys the reality of being in the auto diesel world, being in any trade for that matter of fact, electrician, whatever you are, people will use you. It's just how it is. Just learn to say no, learn to set your boundaries from the beginning. And you know what? I do know one person, he doesn't care if it's friend or family, he charges them no matter what. They all get charged the same thing. He does not care, because he told me once, if they're really your friend and if they're really your family and they really care for you, they will support you no matter what. And he is 1,300% correct. So do whatever you will with this information that I just gave you guys. Obviously I have other videos coming out with the running board lights on the Avalanche and a lot of other stuff. I know how much you guys love those Avalanche videos, but we'll get to it. So I'll see you all for the next one. Peace. If you did like this video, please drop a like, and also leave a comment if you guys yourself have went through any situations like this that what I'm telling you guys about. Leave a comment in the comment section below. Definitely tell me what your experience is, how you guys handle that situation. I'd love to know. And I enjoy talking to y'all. Peace. Make sure you like and subscribe if you're not. I'll see y'all for the next one. Peace.